I'm Ed Wachowski, an art critic and a huge fan of yours. Could you please sign my copy? For Ed, if you will. Your novel is very realistic and engrossing. You appear to be an esoteric arts expert, so perhaps we'll get another opportunity to talk. Thank you so much for the book. Bye.
Hey, I got some exciting news. A new publisher is offering you a multi-year contract. However, they need you to write the new book as quickly as possible. You already know a lot about the urban legends from old Pennsylvania. I believe this is the ideal time to turn it into a story, and Bloody Mary is a fascinating character to explore. So grab your laptop and read up on this legend. I'll do my best to find some information for you as well.
Everyone's talking about your last novel, you know. The newspaper headlines are all about you. Here, take a look. Oh, no.
Hello, I'm Carolina Valenti, the museum's owner. I recognize you. You're that famous horror writer. Nice to meet you. Sorry, we had a minor mishap. The power went out unexpectedly, and I can't seem to locate Henry, our security guard. I hate to bother you, but could you please assist me by turning on the generator? It's near the museum. In the meantime, I'll try to contact Henry. Thank you so much. I'm really lucky that you're good at both writing and electronics. Anyway, now you can take a look at our exhibits. I have to go now, but I hope you'll enjoy the exposition. And once again, I apologize for the mess. Please accept this little present for your trouble.
Thank you.
must see this mirror. It's so cool. Here's a little spoiler. What are you? No, get off me!
Bloody Mary was a beautiful girl from a small village in Pennsylvania. Over the years, her perfect face didn't change at all. She became even more beautiful thanks to her herbal decoction. Envious of her never-fading beauty, the villagers, led by the local miller, prosecuted her for witchcraft. Frightened, Mary decided to hide in the mirror world to wait out the danger, and then return. She discovered a special ritual through... On a dark night, villagers with pitchforks, led by the miller, set Mary's house on fire, preventing her from going outside. The fire spread quickly, and Mary couldn't extinguish it with water. Eventually, her body burned down. Mary had figured out, but she couldn't return.
Another living soul in this cursed place. I'm Henry, the security guard. I've been here for a while hiding from... I can't believe I'm actually saying this. Bloody Mary. This witch or ghost, whatever the hell it is, assaulted me when I arrived here. So, in an attempt to protect myself, I grabbed a shard, and guess what? Her own reflection terrifies her to death. Unfortunately, after a while, she recovers and starts hunting again. When this monster tried to assault Alice, I hurry to assist her. While she's still unconscious, we need to bring this poor girl back to her senses.
For the help. Mary dragged me to this world when I summoned you. And then she... Well, I suppose she tried to drain my vital energy, so I lost consciousness. Oh, they're coming for me! I better hurry! That's her again. Mary, from the legends. I saw portraits of her in the museum that were drawn before she was burned alive in her house. We have to get out of here somehow. Maybe if we follow her, we'll find a way out. These forests are dark. So take this. We must be careful.
Gosh, the house is on fire! Maybe if we perform the ritual that Mary tried to do, we'll have the chance to escape!
Destroy my mirror. Otherwise, you'll have to say goodbye to your friend.
Say what you will about me. I don't give a damn about some literary agent. I'm done with all these mirrors and ghosts!
Stop! Don't break the other half! Then my world would perish, along with your dearest friend and the souls of all the trapped and deceased. Repair my mirror as soon as possible. Otherwise, I won't let this woman go.
Listen, no offense, but I don't give a damn about your Ghostbusters game. Still, you dragged me out of this hell, so I'll help you carry this mirror to our warehouse. Maybe you could repair it there.
Thank you. With my crooked nose and big lips, I stood out among the other girls. Back then, I dreamed of only one. When I turned 13, I ran away from the village. I could no longer stand the bullying. I roamed for a long time before an herbalist. She also promised to teach me her trade and transform my ugliness into beauty. I grew up and settled in the Pennsylvania countryside, and all the village men were fascinated by my new appearance. Only the miller looked at me differently. Despite his broad smile, he didn't seem... So, you managed to repair my mirror. Thanks. Your friend is alive, at least for now.
Oh, and here's our brilliant writer. How's your novel about Bloody Mary coming along?
Miller. Oh, your sorcery still keeps your old body alive. I had a feeling you were involved in this. You will pay for what you've done! I've changed my mind. Your friend stays with me. That warlock accused me of witchcraft and kidnapping. Bring him to me, and I'll set her free. This is your only chance to save her.
Hey, I think I know where N might be. He's been promoting Adam Sanders' antique shop, located at 433 Stam Drive. He's a frequent visitor there.
Begin your search there. When I came to the world of the living, I found it here. It may be useful.
thing we stopped by my shop, Steve.
Yeah, Wachowski will be satisfied with this new sacrifice material. Well then, Sanders, let's take our dear guest to my basement.
You think you're smart? Let me in! Right now!
I saw Steve take a vow from that metal door. There might be some information about Wachowski. I found the valve, so you also can check out that room.
Turns out you're really smart. You know, working for Wachowski was a huge mistake. I've been serving him for so many years. I'm sick of it. The warlock should be at his estate, outside the city. What else? Hey, that's my key. Screw it. Take whatever you want, egghead.
Sanders are both idiots. How did you manage to lose that rider? You don't deserve to be young, or even to live. Now, I have to deal with that hack of a novelist and Mary herself.
Wachowski? Where are you? You can't do this to me!
Thank you.
relax. I won't snitch on you. I wish you no harm. I just had this deal with Wachowski to save my own life. This warlock deceived me as well. He promised me that I would live forever. But all this time he's been blackmailing me and sucking my life force out of me. I want to be rid of him. Once, I overheard a conversation between Wachowski and Sanders. The warlock has discovered a way to weaken him. He got scared and hid the records of this ritual in his estate. These documents are surely encrypted. Find the records and bring them to me, and I'll help you decipher them. That's it! According to these records, one can weaken Wachowski with a special dagger. It should be made of a meteorite that crashed on the night of the Blood Moon. The other day, Sanders and I brought Wachowski some kind of stone. He didn't even touch it, but he was glad that now no one could stop him, and he even praised us. He ordered Sanders to hide this stone in the yard. I think Wachowski might be there. Maybe if you find him, you'll also find out the meteorite's location. You can also check the attic. I'm sure there's something useful there.
So, where's the meteorite?
Oh, once again, I don't know. I asked the caretaker to throw it in the lake.
And why couldn't you do that yourself? Oh, you're so useless. You even let that pesky rider get away. That's it. I'll simply drain your life force, and then get rid of Mary once and for all. It won't be your problem anymore. Oh, darling, don't waste your time. Mary's days are numbered.
Thank you.
try me, Mary. I'm still strong enough to fight you.
Help! Find a way to stop him!
Thank you.
You help me stop the Miller, so I'll keep my promise and let your friend go. My soul is free. Thank you. Oh, thank you.
Almost finished, huh? Oh, believe me, this novel will shake the whole world.